With season 10, Jonesy is in trouble.
Subscribe in 5 seconds or a giant mech will shoot missiles at you.
Okay, not really.
Now that would just be the most ridiculous thing ever.
Gundam in Fortnite is trying to kill me!
Whoa! What's going on?
Whoa, it's the rocket.
No, TAC SMG, come back. Wait,
where am I? Oh my god! Now I'm almost dead!
Oh my goodness, now I'm inside of the hit anime series Gundam, and I'm controlling it. Use code T5G when purchasing any of the new skins as part of the update in the item shop.
Your piggy bank is about to be cracked.
Number 10, cave inside the comet. It's a multi-season world out there right now on the Fortnite Island with references of the OG days spread throughout the whole map in some big and small ways. Now, probably the most obvious thing a lot of you have probably seen by now is the giant comet in the sky. It's kind of hard not to miss, but at the same time, it is pretty cool we get to see exactly what the comet looks like in-game, as during the impact all those seasons ago, we never actually had an in-game event for it, just a cinematic trailer. However, now we have the real thing, and what some of you may not have realized yet is, yes, it is a part of the map where you can walk and build on it. So some of you may have figured this out already, but did you also know that there's some secret caves that can lead you inside the comet too? The main comet itself has multiple chests spread around the top surfaces, but it also has slopes around the edges that act as stairs for you to access the lower levels. On the east side, you can find a little U-bend tunnel with some floor loot inside, but the really awesome part is another cave with an entrance on the west and north side that lead you into a center cave area. Here, you can find more loot, but also the old capsule that the original visitor came out of. You know that little comet that was at the center of Dusty Divot with the metal capsule inside and the visitor came out setting off the rocket? Yep, that's the exact same capsule, except this time it's open. Where's the visitor? God! Number 9, gifting the battle pass. You heard right, Fortnite have finally added the ability to gift battle passes. You can easily find it when in the battle pass tab, just under all the rewards. I'm pretty surprised they haven't done this sooner, but at least we have it now. The best part about this is that instead of holding long-winded battle pass giveaways that involve using third-party websites to transfer the required funds that just take forever sometimes, we can now directly send you a battle pass with no hassle. So make sure to smash like on the video, comment your username below, and we'll select 2 subscribers to send a free battle pass to. Number 8, giant teddy bear in the desert biome.
Now, I'd be lying if I said I didn't overreact to this little map secret, but come on, it's a giant teddy bear.
It's Fred's new best friend. We've seen the teddy bear army growing strong with the Fortnite Island, popping up in random locations in all varieties of ways. Let's just be grateful that this giant teddy didn't get a giant pumpkin head to match. That might have been a little off-putting. In all honesty, it's got all the same mechanics as normal teddy bears, so it'll break in one hit where you'll find some loot hidden inside. I'd have loved it though if you could have broken the walls and he was movable like the old beach ball. Being able to bring your teddy to the Victory Royale with you would actually be a mission of sweaty yet epic proportions. Dad jokes aside, though we've always suspected the teddy bears might be an introduction to the storyline at some point, maybe Epic Games would just mess around with them. But this just adds more evidence to the theory. Next, it'll be a giant mecha monster and teddy fight. Number 7, main slipstream removed. So the slipstream has been something heavily debated throughout the community, as it did have such a big effect on the map and how the game would play out. Yeah, sure, it was a whole bunch of fun and made the game feel a lot more fast-paced, but it also meant you could be chasing people halfway around the map for half the game or get surprise ambushed by the third-party vultures before having time to even think about healing up. Well, now they've actually removed the main slipstream with the Season 10 update. Mega Mall and Neo Tilted still have theirs, so you'll have to be careful in those areas is the map, but having the main slipstream removed is definitely going to change the game for actual fast-paced cross-map traveling. What are your thoughts on this, though? Should they have removed all of the slipstreams, or do you think they made the right call by leaving just the location-based slipstream in? Let us know in the comment section below. Number 6, Wild West Tilted is coming, called Tilted Town. Now, maybe you're wondering where all the big map changes are. There's only a few big changes around the map, but nothing that's an actual significant map change like an entire location or something. The most you'll find right now is around the monster skeleton with all the new pink and purplish trees. However, with every update comes a whole bunch of new files that you know the data miners will be sweating away at like it's some sort of hacker's movie. Well, it looks like the clock just struck 12 at Neo Tilted because it's about to get all Western themed on us. Turns out that a ton of building models have been found inside the game files showcasing this Western theme. You can even find files that specifically say Western, so it's not just a visual guess. Hypex on Twitter claims that this new location will be called Tilted Town. Sounds like a bit of a downgrade, but I guess we'll just have to trust Fortnite with this one. From Tilted Towers to Neo Tilted and next with Tilted Town, present, future, and the past, sounds like to me that this whole season is going to be an OG nostalgia fest, and I can't wait for the season to bring even more changes. Number 5 is the audio changes. As always with Fortnite, the patches are huge. Their download times have gotten better, but when you read the patch notes, there's just so much to go through, and a lot of times, a few tiny yet important details can completely throw you off in-game if you happen to miss them. A few key points to note is multiple audio changes. You may have noticed already while playing, as there's a lot of new impact sounds for bolts. You can also hear distant gunfire and gliders from further away, which you know is going to cause a whole lot more third parties, but at least you'll be less likely to have someone surprise attack you when gliding in. Then finally, they've also increased the volume for chests and the range they can be heard. So every time you weren't quite sure if you could hear a chest behind that wall, you'll definitely be able to tell now. Although I'm sure that was never too much of a problem for all of us Fortnite nerds out there that bleed our ears out with unnecessarily high volume. Just to listen out for those footsteps, you know. Number 4, Gold Tac SMG in the trailer. It's gold! You watch the trailer and one of the first things Blondie tries to grab is a Gold Tac, but why is it gold? When we had the original TAC SMG many moons ago, it only ever went up to purple gray. So at first, you think, okay, well, they're just teasing something that we all want back, but is too OP to come back to the game. And even then, I thought that this thing was dangerous. So to think we might be seeing a gold variant, or the possibility of seeing any kind of gold variant soon, I'm sure has a lot of the community hype. I honestly can't wait for the double gold TAC meta just obliterating squads with your pea shooting Nerf gun that absolutely destroys. It's one of those weapons you expect to not do much, but can be extremely satisfying to use, but how will it appear in game? It looks as though space and time is extremely distorted and unstable across the map, so I wouldn't be surprised if we'll be seeing heavy time changing events all across the island, one in which we'll introduce this fable, Gold Tactical SMG. Number 3 is the orb at Loot Lake is now a rift. Speaking of space and time affecting the map, how could anyone miss that giant bubble of light surrounding the Loot Lake ball? Just like the comet, it appears to be frozen in time, during the very moment it was in the process of exploding. But perhaps it hasn't stopped. There's a lot of theories as to what time is doing right now on the island, but we can be fairly certain we'll be seeing that explosion continue or expand, causing even more changes around the map. Maybe the more it expands throughout the season, the more the map will be changed. Theories aside though, the area is filled with loot. Chest galore, just a bit of slow-paced getting to it all as the entire bubble creates an anti-gravity effect, which I'm guessing is supposed to give the impression of time slowing down within it. Probably the least common knowledge secret about this location at the moment though is that you can actually go into the orb. It essentially has a rift inside that teleports you straight up like normal, and as far as I'm aware, it's a permanent rift. To assume this orb and its frozen explosion of time distorting energy is going to have huge changes on the map as the season continues isn't really just a theory, it's almost a given, or obvious. But aside from the leaked Tilted Town with its Western theme, what locations do you think we'll be seeing? I mean, there's even a Moisty Mire spray paint within the Battle Pass with evidence showing we might get Moisty back again. And yes, we thank the Fortnite gods, got the OG factories back, but what vaulted location do you want returned? Even just for a little while. Number 2 is you can dance in the new Brutes. Fortnite wouldn't be Fortnite without its worldwide known emotes. I'm sure there's an ancient Aztec tribe in South America with someone doing the floss right now. And with Season 10, we've got all the new two-seated mechas known as Brutes. In all honesty, they remind me of a hybrid between Brutes from Halo and the Titans from Titanfall, but put into a Fortnite paint blender. These things have some random spawn locations around the map, and you can even see them on your main map when you bring it up. But when Epic Games added a humanoid-style vehicle, there was one feature they knew they just couldn't miss out on, which was Brute emotes. All your normal emoting works just as normal, but with this mecha in sync, it's a brilliant touch that's definitely going to add some hype and challenges around these new vehicles. Now you just gotta wait until you see the Brute conga line roaming around the newly repaired fields of Dusty. And in number 1, we've got the Winner's Glider. It's a new season, and as always, we get a new Victory Royale glider. Now, the pattern so far showed the winning gliders getting more elaborate with each season. In the last few seasons, they've had little audio effects. However, with Season 10, it looks as though they've gone a bit back to the basics. This umbrella is very simple, mainly black with a hint of purple, and then the X that covers the top to represent Season 10. There's no music that I've heard to it yet, and to be honest, I don't think that's a bad thing. I love choosing the umbrellas because of how much less room they take up on the screen. But at the same time, I don't want to use an umbrella that has a loud music tune that lets everyone in a mile radius numb around like the corner like some sort of ice cream truck. Just let me have my clear visuals and sneak attacks. So for that reason, the Season 10 Victory Royale umbrella is a solid win for me. But hey, don't click off the video just yet. Click on our video to watch the top 10 new Fortnite Season 10 skins that we need. Give it a click. Click the video. There's an annotation on screen right now. Find out some skins that we'd like to see in-game.